Hi, everyone. Thanks. When I registered for this conference, I didn't think I'd had a chance to speak. This is pretty awesome. Probably the biggest audience I've spoken for. This is me. I'm Michiel. But everywhere on the internet, I'm M. Helvens, like the first letter of my first name, etc. And this presentation is about Delta.js, which is a small library that I developed recently. Very recently, so very few stars and forks and stuff, unfortunately. It's not Angular specific, but it works pretty well with Angular. It's based on Delta modeling, which was my PhD research. This is Delta, by the way. So it must be good because it's science, okay? It's about feature-based programming. If you implement a feature in your software, usually there's not one single place where you could put all the code for that feature. It's usually spread around quite a bit. This is a very simplistic example where you add a do new stuff function to this service, and you add like an attribute restriction, and you call the new function inside the controller of that directive there. Like there's three different places, and different features get mixed up and spread around. This is basically the cross-cutting concerns. So a solution that I came up with is variation points and deltas. Variation points, basically you mark the places where changes might happen. And then deltas are able to change those values, and you can basically put all related changes in the same place. So that's this example, but in deltas. So basically, you build the deltas, and the deltas implement your features. And I have a small demo. This should have been working. Okay. So this is Epinetomy, a little application that I'm working on now at the university. So this is basically a three-dimensional environment with a tree map. You can click things and open them up, and they have and a little D3 thingies inside it. This is basically a small demo. And basically this is these are the deltas that implement that application. Every little box is basically a feature. Sorry about that. Anyway, it's about deltas have operations that they can perform on these values. And a couple of very simple ones are modify, add, remove, replace. If you're talking about an object, you can add properties and modify an object to go deeper. Prepend, insert, and append, they work on arrays and functions. And there's a couple of specialized operations, and you can create custom operations as well. So after takes into account that a function might return a promise, and it will wait for that promise to be resolved before firing the new function that you provide with that operation. And I came up with two silly Angular-specific operations too, where you can sort of add a restrict thingy and or remove one. So it's a bit tricky. The partial order that you saw earlier in that diagram basically means which deltas know which other deltas and are authorized to make changes to it. So if you have two deltas that are not related at all, but they still want to change the same thing, there's a conflict. And a way to resolve this, there's a couple of ways. You can make specific operations which don't conflict, like because the order doesn't matter, but sometimes it does. And then you can create like a third delta, which knows the other two, and overrides the value again to properly combine their features. So sort of glue code. Finally, there's feature selection. Software product lines, this is where this formalism comes from. And you can turn features on and off by selecting features in the code. If you write your deltas well, then they will work with any combination, basically. So load only the features you need. It's basically it. Thanks a lot for listening.